Hi friends, I wanted to talk about the interoceptive system, which is our eighth sense. You know, whenever I learned as a child, I always wanted to know the address. So if I'm talking about my eyes and the sense of sight, I used to know, okay, so this is the address of my visual system. Oh, this is the address of my, my sense of smell. Oh, this is my address for my sense of taste. This, you know, my ears is a sense of my listening or hearing rather. Hearing is the sense. So I always wanted to know what's the address. Behind the ear, over here is the vestibular system. In all my muscles, in the tendons and in the muscle spindles, I have the proprioceptors. So I was very keen to know what exactly is this interoceptive system and where is it located. So interoceptive system is present, the interoceptors are present in my muscles, they are present on my skin, they are present across those internal organs. So you know, it gives me an idea about what's happening within my body, which will help me to decide how I'm feeling. From what I just said, it's so very clear that it is very important, this system is very important, and that awareness of my interoceptive system is very important to be able to self-regulate. So what does it do exactly? I met one parent yesterday and I had told them to follow a sensory diet, and the parent had to give some kind of proprioceptive input to the child. I told them it's okay, that they can even make him climb up and down the staircase. It would be a good idea to do that. Now, and there were many other things to it, but one of the activity was that. And the parent met me yesterday and she said, "Reena, I can't make him do the staircase climbing." And I was wondering, like, why is it so difficult for her to do that particular activity? And I thought I should ask more about it. When I asked her more, she said, "You know what, this boy is jumping from one, hopping rather, from one step to the other." So he went hopping for all the 15 floors, and by this time the mother was really panting, she was too tired. The boy didn't sense that he was tired. So it's our interoceptive system which tells us that you're tired. The mother's system was functioning well. She knew that she was tired because she was sweating, her heart was racing. So these cluster of things help us to know what we are feeling at what particular point of time. The mother said the boy had no idea. And he was not getting tired. It is not that the child is not getting tired. It is that the child is not having an awareness of the fact that he is getting tired. That is poor interoceptive awareness. So one of the things that it tells, that it does, is tell us whether I'm tired. Are my muscles sore? Do I need to take some rest? That is one of the things that it does. And there are many other things it does. One more thing that it does is, so I had another parent who came to me and she told me that, you know, her son is doing very well, sitting, focusing, paying attention, like, you know, whatever goals that we wanted to work upon, we had kind of reached there. But there was only one problem that still stayed with him. And she said, you know, if he's eaten well, he's had like his full lunch, and then she starts to eat, he's again wanting food. He wants to eat again. She gives him again, and after 10 minutes again he wants to eat. So he goes on eating and eating and eating as if there's no full stop to eating. That's because he doesn't get that sense of being full, which is again a part of my interoceptive system. It tells us whether I'm hungry. So how do we know that we are hungry? Because the stomach starts growling. That's a sign that we know, oh, we are hungry and we need to eat. In his case, he had the awareness, but he didn't know how much was being full about. So in interoceptive system also, it could be overactive or it could be underactive. And then there are other kinds of kids who I met, the parents who I meet, and they say, you know, the child is never hungry. They don't want to eat. Even if you don't give them food for like 4 to 6 hours, they are comfortable. They do get cranky, of course. They're not, the behavior worsens because of course they need food, but still, you know, they don't understand. They can't sense that they are really hungry. So that's how it fluctuates. Some want to eat too much. Some don't even realize that they are feeling hungry. So that's what the interoceptors give us. That's how they signal us that you're feeling hungry, you're feeling thirsty, you're feeling tired, or you're feeling sleepy. This is all the job of my interoceptive system. Then I had this another boy who would come to me, and he is, I think, now 17 years old. He used to come to me when he was little, I think around 5 years of age, and then he came for around 2 years of therapy. Now he doesn't need therapies anymore. He's sitting, focusing. I think he's in his 10th standard, doing everything well. But there's only one thing that is still not achieved, and we never worked on it. It is now that we started working on. So he says, you know, Reena auntie, whenever I feel I want to go to the toilet, I get to know about it at the last minute, you know. Like, say, if I feel, if we have this urge to go to the toilet, we know, okay, another 15 minutes I can wait, or maybe another 20 minutes I can wait. But he doesn't get that sense, you know. So he gets that sense just before he has to go to the toilet. So that is something that he came to me with. And that, again, is poor interoceptive awareness. So up till now, we discussed the child eating too much, not eating at all, so hunger, thirst, tired, then, you know, the bowel and the bladder. I forgot to mention about one more thing that the interoceptive system does is it gives us the signal that we have pain, or we are not well, you know. So if a child gets hurt, you know, I had this parent who came to me, and they said, you know, my child is very brave. If he falls, he does not cry. He is so brave. Even if, you know, if the skin is like, if there is a skin peeling, he'll just peel it off, but he's not going to cry. But that also shows that he's not receiving those signals. This is something new which we have learned in the original work of Jean Ayers, who founded or who conceptualized the theory of sensory integration. Interoceptive system was not, the interoceptive word was not used, and it's a relatively new thing. So many people don't know about it, and when we know about it, it's important to understand why the child is doing, so that we come from a place of understanding and not judgment. I hope this helps you. I will talk about it in my next video on interoception. Thank you for watching. And if you want to know more about us, and if you want to understand or work with your child and learn how to work with your child, I do conduct trainings. And I do conduct trainings, like one is called Laying the Foundation, which is understanding the sensory system as a whole. Then I conduct trainings on vestibular system, tactile system, proprioceptive system, because once you know all of it, and you know how to give inputs to your child at home, it becomes easier for you to work with your child. Of course, the professional help would be needed, and occupational therapists will be needed to teach you, but you will be fairly equipped to learn how to manage your child. Hope this information helps you. Thank you, and have a great day.